Hey everyone, welcome back to my channel. Today I'm going to be reviewing the world's most full coverage foundation, period. These foundations have literally taken all over social media. I thought, why shouldn't I try out these Dermacol babies out there and see if they work on my face or not. I already have my eyes done and everything. These which I got were 218 and 210. Shade range of the foundation is very tricky. I mean, they mostly have rosy or pink undertone foundations available, Asian skin tone. So I was looking for something which is more yellow undertone and stuff. Got two of them, so I don't have any problem with, you know, the foundation matching my face or anything. So I wanted to make sure that the foundations match my skin, even if I have to mix both of these. It was a package sent to me by Dermacol. It was a very nice, flaky, glittery kind of packaging, and I posted a very nice unboxing on my Instagram and Facebook as well. You can have a look. So this was the bag which in foundations came in, the products came in. It's a very nice glittery bag, and shop from Dermacol for about 2500 rupees or something, you get a bag for free. And it's a very nice bag, guys. I'm definitely considering this to be my makeup bag. Also sent me a Dermacol satin makeup base, and they wanted me to try this foundation out, review this foundation by using this primer underneath. Feel the finish is going to be more smoother since I'm gonna be using it's the brand's primer as well. So let's start this demo and let's see how this goes. Take the Dermacol satin makeup base, and I'm gonna apply this on half of my face. You can see that how amazing is this primer, how it performs, and what difference it creates on both the sides. And take some of it. It's definitely a silicone based primer, but it's very watery.
It smells very nice as well.
Because the formula was very light. It's not sticky or anything. It absorbed very nicely into my skin. Okay guys, so I have zoomed in a bit so you can easily see the application and everything. I want to make sure that you can easily see that. I'm using these two tools to try this foundation out. And for my left side, I'm going to be using the Morphe M444 brush. And for my right side, where my primer has also been applied, I'm using a beauty blender, a damp one. I'm first taking the 218 shade. I'm making sure that I'm gonna take away a little amount since it comes out so much and we don't want to waste product. Runny or anything, it's a very moussey kind of formula. I think this shade will pretty much match my skin tone. I feel I have taken a lot of product. Okay. Oh my god. What? This is... this is definitely a full coverage foundation. My skin looks flawless. Can you see the difference? OMG. It didn't look cakey or anything. I mean, I was expecting it to look very cakey, you know. Kind of a matte finish, but it gives a nice glowy and a little bit satin finish to it. It's not very matte. You can still see some kind of, you know, glow into the skin. it has literally covered all my imperfections. Although I have some pigmentation going around over here in some parts of my face, but this literally has covered it all without using any sort of color correcting tool. It has primer on and this side didn't, so let's see what magic it creates with the help of a primer and beauty blender. Okay, let's dab it now. I feel it's very easy to blend. This foundation works perfectly with both the tools. I mean, it looks flawless. It applied flawlessly, very easily with the help of a brush, and also with the help of a beauty blender it absorbed and blended out amazingly. Like, I didn't have any problems with blending out my foundation or anything. And what I feel is this side looks more glowy than this side is more kind of matte. I feel what the primer made a difference was, it made, since it was a silicone based primer, and silicone based primers are really good for combination or oily skin, since it makes your foundation mattifies very nicely. I personally prefer using them as well. So I'm not sure if you can see this in the camera. I'm telling you this 100% sure that this side is more matte and this side is more like glowy. Also, the application looks more smooth and flawless on this side than on this side. Cool. I don't need any kind of concealing or highlighting right now, but I still want to use the 210 shade to see what it looks like and give a more finished look in my under eye area. Face now, I'm gonna complete rest of my makeup and I'm coming back with my final verdict. Guys, this is what the final look is. I think my makeup, my foundation, my base looks flawless. I say this for a guarantee that my face, my foundation have never looked so perfect and so flawless ever. I'm saying this, it's definitely the most full coverage foundation I have ever used. I don't know about you or about anybody else, how it hid my imperfections, my dark spots, any kind of pigmentation, and was a wonderful experience for me. Coming to the final verdict about these products, the primer is really nice. It's a silicone based primer. It has a very thin consistency when you use it. It absorbs and blends out in your skin very nicely. It creates a very matte difference to the face. If you are a person who is more oilier combination like me, you would definitely need to use this satin makeup based primer to make the skin more mattified. On the other hand, if you are someone who has dry skin, then you don't need to buy this primer. You can just go with the normal primer, whatever you use, and it will work great. Coming to the foundations, I have to say this, but these foundations are the most full coverage foundations out there. I haven't tried any foundation other than this which has this kind of coverage, which gives this kind of flawless coverage. It looks very thick when you apply it on your hand, like a thick moussey texture, but when you apply it on your skin it doesn't feel cakey or anything. It blends out very nicely. I used two tools to blend out my foundation, brush and beauty blender, and it worked amazing on both the sides. This foundation works with both the brush and beauty blender. It blends out flawlessly with both the tools. Foundation for oily skin, normal skin, combination skin, or dry skin. I think this foundation is going to work for all the skin types, since I told you the difference that if you want more mattified skin, then you can go for the primer. You can buy the primer as well. Someone who has dry skin, this is going to work for you as well. This is going to work for all the skin types. That's what I feel. I would recommend this foundation to people who loves full coverage. Like, I'm a person who loves full coverage, but I don't want this coverage every day. You know, I'm a person who wears light formula foundations or BB creams on regular basis. I would wear these, I would wear the Dermacol foundation on some occasion, wedding or something, where I feel I need full flawless coverage. I want to have this foundation for occasions, weddings and stuff like that. You can keep these. They won't expire for more 2 to 3 years. So these won't be a waste for you. But for someone who loves full coverage foundation every day, someone who has acne prone skin or who have lots of scars and hyperpigmentation going on their face, they can definitely use it on their daily basis. It's totally up to them. I'm not sure about the lasting power as now, since this was my first impression kind of video. So what I'll do is I'll mention that in the description box below about the lasting power and everything, how long they stay on your face, the lasting power and breaking out, fading out and stuff like that. I'll mention that in the info box below. I love the fact that these foundations are what they claim to be, since the claim was to make your face flawless and give you a full coverage finish. So I think this hits that mark for me. These foundations are only available at Dermacol eShop Pakistan. It's a Facebook page, official distributors of Dermacol brand. Link that in the description box below. Foundations are not pricey at all. It's each for 900. I mean, when you're getting such a full coverage foundations, 900 bucks is not a huge amount for me. Yes guys, this was my final verdict and review about these foundations. I hope you found this video helpful and it answered all your questions. I will see you guys with my next video very soon. Till then, bye.